Welcome back. So we just finished talking about dry ingredients and how easy it is to convert dry ingredients from their, you know, cup measurements to a weighted measurement and how important that is. But how do we address liquid measurements? Because they often come in fluid ounces, liters, gallons. How do we convert those items into a weighted measure? And you might be asking me, why, Natalie? Why are we converting it to a weighted measure? Well, it's because throughout Chef Equation and throughout all of our baker's percentage formulas, we're using weights to scale our recipe up and down. And a fluid ounce of one liquid does not weigh the same as another liquid. For example, a cup of water weighs 8 ounces. It's 8 fluid ounces. It's kind of like our baseline, our standard. But a similar cup of milk weighs a little bit more. Buttermilk is even a little more heavier. And then if you saw me pick up that gallon of corn syrup, one cup of that is going to be really heavy if compared to water. So how do you convert your measures as you're going through your recipes into liquid measures? We're gonna have to do this in Chef Equation when you purchase items, right? Because you need to know how many ounces are in a gallon of something. And one way you can do it is just by putting a container on a scale. When you get your next bottle or jug of milk, get yourself a big container and go ahead and fill your container with milk until you get the weighted measure. And then pour it right back into your gallon jug. An example of that, if I were to try to figure out how much my bottle of root beer that I'm about to have for lunch, my bottle of root beer weighs, I can take a container, put it on my scale, tear it out so that it zeroes out, pop that top, and weigh it out. Bubbles and all. So if you're making root beer cake, here's how you would calculate that 12 fluid ounces of root beer is the equivalent of 12.7 weighted ounces. 12.7 weighted ounces for 12 fluid ounces. So obviously it weighs a little bit more than water, because if this were filled with 12 fluid ounces of water, then its weight would also be 12 fluid ounces. That's why it's so important. That's why it's so important to go ahead and weigh all of your ingredients as you put them into your pantry and Chef Equation so that you get accurate weighted measures. I have a cheat for you too. There is an amazing calculator online that I've been using for several years. It's old school. It looks old school, but it's accurate and it works. It's called aqua-calc. And I have a feeling it was designed initially for converting weighted measures, volume measures to weighted measures, liquids to weighted measures, because it's called aqua-calc. But now it does all kinds of amazing conversions. Let me introduce you to aqua-calc while I add some ice and enjoy my root beer. Let me give you a quick tour of aqua-calc. Aqua-calc I stumbled upon when I was trying to do tons of conversions all at once and I was getting tired of doing measurements and I was like, hey, I gotta create these Excel documents and I don't have time to go to the grocery store and buy one of everything and measure it out. So I did some Google research and found aqua-calc. Let me show you what it looks like. To get to aqua-calc, we're gonna start by typing in aqua-calc.com, and usually it pops up for me with the food volume to weight. So I'm gonna go to aqua-calc.com and it pops up and it looks like this, and it's pretty information full, right? First thing I'm gonna do is close the pop-up at the bottom. And it comes in with US cups and we need to give it more information. We're going to start by putting in what we're trying to search. And let's say for us, we're looking for buttermilk right now. I bought a gallon of buttermilk, and I need to know how much that gallon of buttermilk weighs so I can put it into my chef equation pantry. So I start by typing in buttermilk and enter for search. And it's going to pop up something random here. And it's because when we hit the drop-down menu bar, we see all of the different things in aqua-calc's conversions that include the word buttermilk. I like to buy buttermilk whole, none of that fat-free stuff. Buttermilk whole, and I can see when I click on buttermilk whole, 1 cup is 8.61 ounces. Note that it's not 8 ounces. It's not as light as water. It's 8.6 ounces by weight. Now I bought a gallon, I didn't buy a cup. So I'm going to come up here at the top where it has the volume measurement and scroll down until I see the US gallon. And I can see by clicking US gallon that my 1 gallon container has 137.71 ounces inside. And I didn't have to pop the top. I didn't have to put it on a scale. It's already in the aqua-calc. I hope this was helpful. This calculator contains all kinds of different conversion styles. You can do, gravel by weight. You can do all kinds of cool conversions. But I find that the food calculator is the most important in what I do and in my industry. And I hope you get to use aqua-calc occasionally to create your conversions without having to weigh it out. That wraps up turning volume measures into weighted measures. I look forward to seeing you in the next lesson.